हेलो डियर कलीग्स, आय मिसेस संपदा कुलकर्णी फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इन्फॉर्मेशन टेक्नॉलॉजी मॉडल कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग वेलकम्स यू फॉर वन वीक ईएफडीपी ऑन ई कंटेंट डेवलपमेंट एंड इफेक्टिव यूज ऑफ आईसीटी। दिस ऑनलाइन एफडीपी इज ऑर्गेनाइज बाय मॉडल कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग। हियर इन दिस वीडियो सेशन आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग यू ग्रेड्स टैब इन द गूगल क्लासरूम। For the grades tab, in the teacher's role, that what the teacher can do, that I am going to explain you in this video session. But keep in mind that the grades tab is not present in the student's login. The students is not able to see the grades tab as the student is having only the three tabs. They are streams, classwork, and the people. Here you can see this is the students login and stream, classwork and people. Only these three tabs are available with the student. But now let's move to the teacher's login. Teacher's login is having four tabs, that is stream, classwork, people and grades. Now how this grades tab is helpful for the teacher? Here you can see that the grades given to all the assignments that are appear in the grid format. Here the first row is give you the due date for that particular submission. The second row will give you the name of the assignment. Third row will give you the category of the assignment, that is either lab assignment, internal assignment or something else. And the last row will give you the total marks assigned to that particular assignment. So all these things are set by the teacher itself. Now here we will see the columns. The first column is nothing but the list of the student, where you can sort all the students by either last name or the first name. The second column is for the overall grade. If you don't want this overall grade, you can off it in the settings of the grades part. Here in this setting you can see over here to show the overall grade or not. Here show overall grade to students is on, that's why the overall grades are there. And overall grade, if you will close it, then that overall grade is not able to or is not visible. Now I'm keeping this it as on, and there will not be any change in this your grade section. This overall grade you can see over here. Now this is the row which is helpful to see the overall class average for every assignment as well as for the overall grade. If n number of students are there, all these rest of rows will be for n number of students. You can see all the n number of students over here, and you can check the performance of all that n number of students over here. So if the student has done the submission, you can see the marks written or graded marks by the teacher for all the assignments. This assignment is not having any marks assigned, so that's why if the student has done the submission, it will only show you that the submission is done. And for those you have not given the grade to that particular student, you can give the grade to this particular student by viewing the submission. And you, if you will click on this what we can say tab, it will move to that particular assignment whatever the students has submitted this particular assignment. And here you can give the grade to the student according to student's submission. So suppose if I am giving the 18 marks to for this particular submission, and here I am clicking on this return button, so what it will do, it will assign 18 marks for this particular submission. And after this you can see the changes in the grade book. And here you can see the 18 marks are assigned to this particular student for the assignment which was not graded by me or not returned by me. So here in this way you will be able to see 18 marks out of 30 are assigned to this particular student which was not graded or written by me previously. So in this way, if you have done with all the submission of that particular student, you can see that the overall average or the overall grade earned by that particular student. So in this way, this grade tab is very helpful to go through the overall grade of the student or the submission done by the student. So thank you all my dear colleagues for listening and watching my video. Here I have done with all the information or the manual, video manual for Google Classroom. I hope all of you are doing well with this Google Suite. Here for your reference, I am providing the shortcut link for the next video of my channel or the next topic from our FDP, that is a Google document. And after this, I am providing you a shortcut link for a playlist of this Google Suite. Thank you and stay tuned with Tech Talks.